So this is the my Mesa Boogie Nomad 55. Fantastic amp. It does everything. So many different sounds. There's actually three separate channels in this amp. It's a 55 watt amp. I actually run it a little bit differently than probably a lot of people. The cabinet that you can see here is actually just one 15 inch speaker. It's actually a bass speaker. It's the Mesa Boogie Black Shadow 15 inch, running at 55 watts. And the reason that I've matched the two with this, this is kind of a rock country type head. And I just love the clean tones and the vintage rock tones that it creates. And it also has, like I said before, a phenomenal amount of push to get almost like a Mark II C plus heavy metal tone out of it as well. But because it's got that kind of twangy range, I wanted more grunt, more low end for playing seven string guitar, for playing heavy rock, for playing progressive metal, that kind of stuff. So I paired it with that 15 inch and I get a lot of really deep, rich tone out of it. I'm on the clean channel now, which is here. There's actually a switch on each of the channels, and on channel one, which is clean, you have clean normal, and then you can go to a pushed, which is, I suppose, full power, and this is about half power. The second channel, we have a vintage and normal, or vintage and modern. Vintage, modern. And then in channel three, there is a modern, which is the normal mode, and a vintage mode, which is, again, it's kind of that half thing. The other cool thing is, if you look here, there's an output control. This is your master overall output. And then there's also a solo switch, so it's just a boost, which is really, really cool. And so we're gonna go through these right now. There's also on the foot switch, a reverb switch, a control to turn it on and off. Each of these channels has an independent reverb control, so you can control the amount of reverb on each channel. I actually don't like reverb at all. I never use it, except in a recording situation, but for my amps, I always have it off because I prefer to use a delay in my channels. So here's the clean channel, channel one. This is in the clean normal setting. So you can see there's quite a lot of twang. So let's go to the pushed mode. So there's the clean, we're gonna go pushed. So you get kind of a lot of really good push out of that. That's the clean channel. But it's such that you can actually roll that off. So as you roll down, it actually cleans it up considerably. Now we'll go to channel two. You can use this amp at bedroom levels for all of you bedroom rockers out there. And again, you can dial this back a little bit and get a cleaner tone, but in this channel, you never really get rid of that grunt. So that's the vintage. I really, really, really like it. It's perfect for bar rock, classic rock, hard rock, pop punk. Now we'll go to the channel three. A lot of grunt out of that, and again, you can probably hear, this is just crappy camera audio, by the way, but you can hear there's a ton of bass response out of this, and again, that's mostly due to that 15 inch speaker. I'm gonna turn you, I'll show you the vintage mode here just to give you an idea of what it does. It cuts out a lot of the high end, I find, on this channel. And I don't really like that, so I always use it in a modern. I never go to vintage mode in Channel 3. That's the Nomad 55, the way I run it. There is an effects loop built into the amp as well, which is fantastic. There is a wet and a dry mix, or wet-dry mix channel, so you can actually change the amount of effects loop in the head per channel, again, which is really, really good. Versatility is key with this amp and with my setup.